screw this one up. Oh, I'm so nervous for the last one. And we need more than one land. Still need to draw more than one land. F6. So we need a land, it's not tapped. Well, the good news is he might not know what we're running. So, that's four land drops, or land draws we missed in a row. Just for those of you keeping track at home. Good news is this guy can untap a gate if we draw a gate. As our next one. Yeah, that's great. That's freaking great. Really not happy about this. And we draw the gate. Freaking A. Mulligan and if we win this game, it'll be freaking dark. Probably not gonna happen. Yeah, extort 4/4. Alright, so we can actually. Alright. We need to stop the bleed. So we need to cast this guy. So bleeding is slowed. So it's just gonna extort me down to nothing, probably, before I can recover. Okay, so I can cast Verdant Haven or Krokonura or the Slime. I think that Krokonura is what I gotta cast. Take out the flyer there, but you know, he just has way too much of a head start on me. I don't think I can pull this out. No, I think I can, I don't think I will. Maybe he runs out of spells and gets mana flooded. So we got a mug at that out of the way. And then slime for 4. Yep. I think I'm gonna go ahead and attack because I gotta get him on some sort of clock. I don't think he's going to block, because I've got too much stuff, but if he does, I can zero-toss slime. whatever it is, and does it with the throw. So he's just jumping. He's in a sack. Or he could smite me. There's always that option. So that's so bad. Maybe I should protect. So I could mining slime for its greatest power. So I could get one, another one power guy. Oh, I'm so good. I'm just gonna sleep. It's great. Alright. So I don't want to run swing because I just want to be attacking. Especially I'm going first, so let's not do that. And I think we'll just run it as is. Yep. Alright, this is so depressing. What is up with his hands? Yeah, I have to mop in the Alright, there's a hand. So, leap of oil speaks. So, I don't know whether I want to cast Carpenter or the Verdant Healing next turn. This is the first time I've actually had this guy in my hand. This is match 4. He hasn't done anything yet, so I'm just going to try him. I don't have anything to rank him. I don't have a 5 drop. Or I don't have... I know I have a 4 drop, that's right. Alright, so I'm just going to predict that I don't draw and land next time. So, because I said that for sure, I will draw land. That's alright, because land's worked well without a hook. Basilica Girds. Yep, we laugh at your Basilica Girds. We are bigger than you. We're stronger than you. We're higher on the food chain. And of course, I do draw that land. Not that it matters. Alright. So we're just gonna draw up the Rampagers. We're just gonna try to get to work with the Rampagers. Would like to have the Crocodile first. I really wish I Alright, we gain life at least. So we're at 5 now, right? Yeah, so I can cast healing and him. So I cast. Crocodile first, and then I get the ball trigger. Okay. So we've got some stuff going on here. He looks like he's stuck on 3 land. Well, he's done a fine job of fighting through it. I have to admit. I have to give him credit for that. Back, he found his fourth land. That's so unfortunate. little slow. The floor is off. It's, I think that's pretty good. Decided to not to do that. Alright. So, let's think. I can attack and block Rebel Hulk. I think I'd rather Rebel Hulk than Gorkman or Preacher. They're both plus fours, but no trample, but I can actually cast him next turn. Although if I draw another land, I'll be mad about that. Let's see. He gets two. I can just trade the True Fire Paladin. Best option is, oh wow, it's gonna be really, yeah, I can't blood rush and drop a watcher afterwards, so that's gonna be really, so if I just bluff attack with Kimura and drop the gore, the rampager. Assuming he's going to block, there's no reason not to do this. I'm going to just drop the main pitcher afterwards. He evolves. He's evolving. So if I draw another land next turn, the True Fire Paladin alone can get through the Silica Guards. So I can actually just attack with everybody. Oh, it'd be really nice if you just, like, did nothing right here. I'd be good with that. So, Guild Gate means I can cast him next turn. 5-5. That's decent. And, let me think. Attack with both of these guys. He tries to double block, I can shenanigan him up. He can't. Yeah, he can't attack with him yet. So we'll attack here. Probably just get through for four. Tries a double block. Okay, so he's going to become nine. Yeah. Unfortunately, I can't cast my watcher, but that's okay. So, even though he's still at 19 life, my board situation is really good, especially with this guy and free mana. Because, not such a bad card to lose. improve cheap. Interesting that they still mention how much life you paid on the card, and after it happens, it's kind of irrelevant. So he's trying to scramble for something, some way to save his ass. I don't think he's gonna find it. Man. He does have a lot of cards in hand, but I mean, any of these guys can kill him pretty quick. So, he's not going to hurt what's going on. The bar of flesh. I think I'm going to take the Cronulla out because he's more dangerous with the free mana. Chose not to extort. So he's got one more play here. Maybe I should have gotten rid of the Paladin instead, because he is a I think I can just win this turn. Tapped out. So, yeah, I can just we're on the draw now, so this game could go all the ways. I'm not sure. Maybe the third range should be boring is too much. I could add a Darren Skydrake. That could be interesting. Kind of unreliable to cast on turn two. But we do have two planets and two bonus gate gates. And for the prism and the haven, cast a little bit later. I want to be a little bit quicker against him. So I got 9 red sources and 8 green sources, 4 white sources in terms of lands. Tempting to cut a forest and add plains, but that would take me out of these two, or make it more harder for me to cast these two early green drops. I need a fixer there, so I'll go as is. I'll just run it like I want it. Yeah. I do actually have things I can cast, or good cards, when I get up there.
I think I'm gonna keep it.
This guy's a beating, it has a beating. I think I'm gonna draw my white cards, my white two drops. He mulliganed once, so I won't mulligan. And mulligan again for me. He's thinking about it. So that's good. No, he kept it. Okay. Alright, we don't need to draw any more of those. Alright, so we can fix your mana now. Draw a card. We've got action. Interesting. Alright, so we want to draw with the Crocodora next. We'll draw a 3-drop. Or I'll take a 2-drop too. Anything but like land. Speak of the devil. Him. A massive wave that get up to 5 creatures on the deck. Yeah. Find some way to erase that. And you can just sit back and block anything. So, I'm trying to think, do I want, if I attack, I don't need to attack anyway for sure. I don't know if I want to Blood Rush, it doesn't give me a chance. It's kind of disappointing, I haven't used this to actually fix my mana, almost never. Please don't draw me another land. Christ. Please play 4 life, please play 4 life, please play 4 life. She's probably gonna go and play 4 life. Can't win. He's at 8 life. How many cards in my deck could I win with here? He blocks like that. So... yeah. So I'm doing 1 damage to him and wiping his board. Yeah, if I drew the Rebel Hulk, I could win this turn. That's it. Would have worked there. Scorchwalker. I wouldn't. The way he ordered his walkers quickly. He wouldn't even trample through for enough. That wouldn't even trample through for enough. Maybe he wouldn't have done this. Yeah, maybe the Rebel Hulk. That's extremely disappointing. Extremely disappointing. Alright, so I'm going to try the Rose off next, I think.